Hello everyone, so today I'm going to be showing you a quick tip on how to properly displace and export a landscape in Cinema 4D using the displace modifier. So let's get started. First of all, you create a plane. Let's make this 1000 by 1000 centimeters. For good detail, let's have the height segments at 300 by, well, it's not 300 by 300. Okay, let's see, let's the detail per se by changing the view mode to Garut shading lines. Good, now with our plane created, we are going to introduce a displace modifier to our scene. Make this displace modifier a child of the plane. Then once the displace modifier is selected, we come to, don't change anything on the channel, just leave it to custom shader. Click on shader. We're going to add a layer per se. Generally a layer is used to add multiple effects or shaders stacked on each other to create detail in your object. So we're going to go to shade layer. Let's click on it to get inside it. We're going to introduce a noise shader. Okay, under noise, click on noise. We're going to change this to a blistered turbulence. Good. We're going to change the number of octaves to 10, the global scale to 1200%, the delta to 400%. Okay. And the seed to about 345. As you can see, ladies and gentlemen, let's change this back to Garut shading. We have some pretty impressive detail on our plane ready. So this will be good as a landscape, but that is not what we're going for. We're going to create a river in the middle here, or a furrow or a canyon. And I'm going to show you how to do that in a minute. So under this displace modifier, still, let's go into layer, add another shader, but this time we're going to add a gradient shader. As you can see, we've just lost detail. That should not be a problem, because we're going to pretty much go crazy with this in the next few seconds. So let's click on gradient. We'll get in. We're going to shift the black side to the middle, or the black notch. I don't know what people call this. Then we're going to add another one here and make this white. Okay. As you can see, the area with the blacks have a depression of some sort, or a canyon. That is where we're going to create our canyon, or where our river is going to pass through. So we're going to move this closer. And the same applies to this, like so. Good. Now with that done, we're going to change the turbulence to 23%, the number of octaves to 10, and ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, we have a pretty detailed depression or river. You can make a canyon using this method, that depends with you. So the seed is usually used to create variation. So if we change this to 1, it's a different variation, 2 is a different variation, 3 and on and so forth. So we're just going to go with 2, and then we're going to get out of our gradient shader. Now with this done, we are going to go back to, we need to make this depression a bit more deeper. So we are going to get out back to our displace. With our displace modifier selected, we are going to go to object. We are going to add a height of 120 centimeters. As you can see, we really went crazy with that. We have some pretty jagged edges. That is not what we are going for. So how do we fix this? We're going to go back into our shading, click on our layer, reduce the gradient to about 50, okay, and the noise to about 2% or 3% as such. So let's render this and see the outcome. So what we have here is not a bad furrow or depression, but we need to modify this. You can tweak this further, but let's go with about 40. Good, now we are going to convert this into a mesh per se, or something we can use in an external software. So is right click on the plane, select children, right click on the plane again, connect objects plus delete. That will make it one object. But as you can see, when you do a render, it's a pretty jagged mess we have here. So we are going to make this a bit smoother by adding a subdivision surface, making the plane a child of the subdivision surface. Like so, as you can see, that smoothed out our furrow. Let's do a quick render, see how this works. Ah, that is good, that is good. But the thing is, it's going to give you a bit of some problems in another software. So what we're going to do, let's reduce the subdivision editor to 1. Subdivision renderer to 2. That will sort out with the problem of having a heavy mesh per se. So with this done, we are going to right click again and select children. Where is it? Select children. Then we are going to right click again and connect objects plus delete. And we are done. Now we can go ahead and export this as our mesh. So we go to file, export, wavefront obj. Let's make this into call this landscape 2. And click save. Leave things as they are here. And click OK. So it's saving that. Good, and that is it, that is done. So we can go ahead and maybe add a new material per se, but you're going to change all that in Lumion, like so. Then save our obj file. I will just overwrite that one. Overwrite landscape 2, click save. So we're going to close this once this is done saving and import the OBJ into Cinema 4D and see if it's really a mesh or if our lesson for today was a success. Good. File. Close. No, file, open, landscape 2, obj file. Good, as you can see, it was a pretty huge file, 333 MB, but it's required, because if you're going to go for a realistic look in a third party software, I think we need to have the biggest details we can afford. Of course, you can reduce the size of this. I can show you how, using something like we've just imported it and it is as it is. We can use something like a polygon reduction modifier per se, and then add this here and let it do its thing. Once it's done, it's going to pop up here. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you learned something new today. Kindly subscribe and like my YouTube channel. You can like this video. Leave a comment in the section below if you want more of this content in future. Thank you and have a good day.